Then we looked at elements. So today we'll be looking at the electronic configuration of some elements, that is basically the first 20 elements. So we'll be taking our time to draw some of them. We are going to talk about the electronic configuration of the elements. Now when we are talking about electronic configuration, we are looking at how electrons are being arranged on the shells of an atom. Last time we looked at the shell of an atom, how it looks like, the protons and the neutrons found inside the nucleus, as well as the electrons moving on the shells. So let's see. An atom like calcium, you know that it's having atomic number of 20. Atomic number of 20. Then it means if this is a neutral atom, the number of electrons should also be equal to 20, because it's neither gaining nor losing electrons. So the electronic configuration of calcium will be, but basically, if you are drawing the electronic configuration of any element, that is the first 20 elements, they follow the principal quantum numbers. When I say principal quantum numbers, they are the K shell, the L, the M, and the N. These are the principal quantum numbers, shells, the main shells on which electrons are found. So any element that we are going to draw for the first 20 elements, we will be arranging the electrons under these shells. The total number of electrons that K shell should take is 2. Then for L, it should be 8. For M, it should be 8. For the first 20 elements, N should be 2. Apart from that, it can be 3 or 4 moving upward. But for the first 20 elements, this should be the maximum for K, that is 2 electrons, L, which is 8, M, which is 8, and N, which is 2. Now these maximum number of electrons are following rules named as doublet rule and octet rule. When we say doublet rule, we are talking about the K shell, that its maximum number of electrons that it should take should be 2. That is why we say doublet rule. The maximum number of electrons that K shell should take should be 2. When you go to L and M, they obey octet rule from octagon, oct, number 8, meaning the total number of electrons that should enter both L and M should not exceed 8. That is to be fully filled, or shouldn't be less than 8 to be fully filled. Now for calcium, let's see. Even before we draw, we can say that if we have K, L, M, N. Let's see, K should take 2. 2 minus 20, you get 18. So the rest, you spread it here. So this one will take a maximum of 8. This one will take a maximum of 8. 2 plus 8 making 10, plus 8 making 18. Then the rest is what? 2. So this should be the arrangement on the electronic configuration. So let's go ahead. So we have the nucleus there, as protons and neutrons inside. The first shell, which is K, should take 2. The next shell, which is L, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, maximum. Then the next one, which is M, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the last one, which is N shell, 2. This is the electronic configuration of calcium. This is how you are expected to represent it. Now let's draw another one, that is aluminium, and see. AL, aluminium. AL. Now aluminium is having the atomic number 13. So it means that the number of electrons there, because it is a neutral atom, it should be 13. Let's arrange. K, L, M, N. K should pick 2, L should pick 8, And then 10, let's see. 2 plus 8 making 8. Sorry, 10. 2 plus 8 making 10. So minus 13, it means we have 3 left and the 3 will enter this. What will be left for n? To be 0. So this will be the representation. So let's draw it. We have the key shell 1, 2. Next shell, which is L, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And the last shell will be 1, 2, 3. That is aluminium. Let's draw the next element as fluorine, F, atomic number 9. Fluorine, F, atomic number 9. Let's arrange first. We have K, L, M, N. The first one will pick 2, minus 9, still suppress 7. This will pick 7, because it is not up to 8. So we can't give N 2. So we have this will be 0, 0. Now let's draw. 1, 2. Then the K shell will pick 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the last one, 7, for L shell. The last element that we are going to draw is atomic number 18. Atomic number 18, which is argon. Atomic number 18, which is argon. Let's arrange it on the table first. K, L, M, N. K will pick 2, L will pick 8, then 2 plus 8, 10. Still extra to go. Then the rest of the 8 will enter M. 2 plus 8, 10 plus 8, 18 equal. Here will be 0. Then let's represent it. We have first shell as K, 2. The next shell, we have 8 on it. The next shell, another 8 on it. Very simple. So this is the electronic configuration of argon, fluorine, aluminium, and calcium. Now for your trial test, draw the electronic configuration of we have chlorine Cl, atomic number 17. Number 2, we have phosphorus P. In fact, let me clean off the atomic numbers, you have to know. Then the third one, you're going to draw for magnesium, Mg. Then the fourth one will be potassium. You're going to draw for all these elements and you submit it at the appropriate time. Now, having known the electronic configuration of these elements, then let's move on. Okay. Now, we are moving on to what we call bonding. Bonding. When we say bonding, because you already know how ions are formed, we know the electronic configuration of elements, we know what elements are meant about, we know matter, we know atoms, we know molecules. Now let's move on to bonding. Now when we say bonding, let me give a slight example for you to understand. Let's say you are in your house and in your house, your mother is a kinky seller. In fact, I'm talking about black kinky. If your mother is a black kinky seller and you are poofy, and then you also have another person called Kwaku. Now, Kofi's mother sells kinky, and Kwaku's mother too, she sells what we call, let me see, something few to, for you people to understand, called Sheto. Now, if Kofi wants to enjoy the kinky, Kofi can't enjoy the kinky alone. He needs what? Sheto to add to it so that they can enjoy. But Kwaku too is also hungry. And Kwaku is not willing to give everything to Kofi to go and add to the kinky to enjoy. So what they will do is that Kofi can bring kinky, Kwaku also brings Sheto. They bring it together, they enjoy it. So Kofi and Kwaku will be together, then they will be eating. So as they are together at that time eating, They are causing what we call bonds. Meaning, they've gotten... Okay, meaning they are sharing things in common. They are sharing things in common. From there, whenever that Kofi will get kinky and Kwaku will get shito from the mother, they can easily bring it together to eat kinky and shito. That is meant by bonding. So in bonding, having this idea, we are going to explain how bonding occurs. Let's look at an element for chlorine, that is Cl, having atomic number 17. If you are to expand it within the electronic configuration or to draw the electronic configuration, you see that K is having 2, L is having 8, and M is having 7. Meaning, in order to obey the octet rule, 8 electrons in a shell rule, you have to get an extra 1 electron added to the 7 before it can be able to obey the octet rule. Now, if you have another element called sodium, having the atomic number 11, when you are to draw KLMN, you could see that K will pick 2, L will pick 8, and M will pick 1. Now let's see. Now, M for chlorine needs extra 1 before it is fully filled, making it 8. Now, M here for sodium also needs extra 7 before it will be fully filled. According to bonding, if you need 1, if you need 2, if you need 3, getting these is very simple. But if you need 5, if you need 6, if you need 7, it's very difficult. Why? Because when a person needs only 1 electron to be fully filled, that is, it will be having 7. Giving the 7 to somebody is more difficult than giving 1 to be fully filled. So electrons or elements that are having 1, 2 or 3 outermost electrons, they usually give it away so that they will be fully filled. They usually give it away so that they will be fully filled. Now electrons or elements that are having 5 electrons, 6 electrons, 7 electrons there, they don't usually for bonding. If the electrons there are either 1, 2 or 3, they will usually give it away and they will form positive charge ions. And when they are 5, 6, 7, they will usually receive extra so that they will be fully filled. So basically, when we say bonding, it's the interaction between two elements so that their outermost or their electrons will be fully filled, obeying octet rule or doublet rule. So if you have chlorine and you have sodium, chlorine needs 7, sodium needs 1. So sodium will be willing to give the 1 to the chlorine so that the chlorine will get 8 and the sodium will have 0 here, making it obey the octet rule. Then this one too will obey the octet rule. So after everything, sodium and chlorine will come together forming sodium chloride. And we say that this is a compound formed as a result of bonding.